Hi and welcome, everyone. Thanks for joining our conversation on top five SLOs we see at our Dynatrace customers and how to get there. I'm a PM at Dynatrace, driving efforts to make the product even more valuable for every developer's workplace. And I'm joined by my partner in crime, also a PM, Christoph.
Hi, Wolfgang. I'm also a PM, but I actually focus on our customers. I'm a practice manager for our autonomous cloud innovation team. So I actually work together with Wolfgang, spreading the voice of our customers so he knows what we need to do.
Yeah, great. Thanks. So Google already told us what to do, and they already told us about the real challenge of setting up SRE concepts and implementing SLOs. And what we tackle now is, yeah, how to get to the proper SLOs that really provide value for your business. But when it comes to our customers, Christoph, please tell us, what did you see?
Yeah, customers come in all kind of, you know, like sizes, right? So we have customers who are completely new to this topic. They have never heard about SLOs and or SREs. They want to know more about it, but it's all completely new. And then we have probably the majority of the customers that are actually watching this video. They're attending SLOconf, right? So now they want to get themselves some SLOs. Where do they start is the question that they are asking. And then we have customers who are a bit more advanced. They've read the SRE handbook and they want to implement the best practices that are described in there, but they also need to know, well, which are the good metrics that I can use to implement this. And then we have organizations who approach it from an SLA perspective, from the service level agreement perspective. They want to turn those into SLOs in order to track and visualize them to act as early warning indicators. But in summary, what it all boils down to is that we have all these data points. We have a lot of metrics. We have a lot of systems that provide us with information about how our system is performing. But how can we boil down all that data into, you know, check engine lights that can help us really establish how our organization is doing instead of thousands of metrics? So Wolfgang, can you walk us through and kind of like the decision tree that customers go through when they are defining their SLOs?
Yeah, we see that there are specific questions one has to answer and you have to consider. And well, straightforward would be many endpoints, many API endpoints, so many SLOs, of course, yeah, and you are there. Well, it should not be that easy because you end up again with a lot of data, too much data then. So think about what really matters. Think about the UIs of your application, the user actions, specific use cases and click paths through your system. And then, of course, you can still think about the API endpoints. You already mentioned SLAs. So SLAs, of course, already describe what really matters for your business. So think about what does the SLA describe and what metrics does it refer to? What are the questions that are answered there? On the other hand, and quite on the opposite, is what is the real user customer experience and satisfaction? And that's something totally different, because with SLAs, you will find more the legal requirements based on time windows. For example, any uptime in the financial business that you need to provide for your customers. On the customer side, you want to measure the real availability. So if a specific request of a specific customer has success, so what is the customer success in their own experience? And when it comes to experience, of course, performance matters a lot. Performance, we have the proof out there, is something that really is reflected directly in any business revenue. If the system is slowing down, you will just lose deals or lose any customers going through your online shop. And when it comes to the business numbers and the money, of course, what really matters is the overall business success measurement. So if you have metrics out there that count your sales numbers, that do a count of how many customers do really now at the end of any wizard of any web shop really do the payment. And if you have that numbers, use those for your SLOs, of course. And what also matters a lot for the money is, of course, the resource constraints or resource consumption of your system. And this can change with each and every software version, as we all know. So really also do the measurement on the cost aspects of your software system. So answering all those questions is very important. And to finally have some specific SLOs, and Christoph, please tell us, what are those SLOs that we see customers really care about?
Yeah, awesome. Thank you, Wolfgang. So you basically gave us a theory. Now let's see how this translates into the field, into practice, right? So we have customers that look at user application satisfaction. How happy are the users with my platform? Now, how do you measure that? It seems like a personal metric, right? And even depending on the day or your mood that you're in. So we actually have a standardized metric for that called Application Performance Index, or short APDEX. And it's a complex metric. It takes a lot of things into account, like response time, failures, particular actions. And we get a number from 0 to 1. And number from 0 to 1 is something that is easily turned into an SLO, of course. And so we can start looking at that. So we devise a query that gives us that data. Yeah. And the next one is around certain API endpoints, the success rate of those endpoints. Are they actually working as advertised, right? So you define what is good and bad on your individual API, because that is not always the same. But then once you have that, you can get that rate metric that gives you a percentage of successful calls. And of course, that is maybe a slightly more complex metric, but you just take the number of successful calls and you divide them, of course, by the total number to get a rate metric, easily turned into an SLO. And then as you have key APIs, you will also have key actions. Not every action is created equal and should be treated as equally important. Some of them have direct impact to the business. Things like add to cart, checkout, transfer money, right? Book a seat, something that makes you as a business your business, is something that you should track separately. You know, so you could look at, for example, the speed index of those key actions. Again, a key metric that we calculate and that we can use as a base of our SLO. And then up next, right, we have metrics like, synthetic availability, the mother of all measurements, often called, because it's something that's been around for ages and it's the true metric that gives us a real idea of the availability and the performance actually as well of my application or of my action. So you want to use synthetic tests to get that consistency in there. And of course, it's easily turned into an SLO, and in a lot of organizations is used as an SLA as well, right? So, you know, we could query that and even filter out maybe our maintenance windows, right? As you are having those in your application, you don't want to count those towards your availability. And then talking about costs, right? We had costs already there with our key actions, right? They drive the business, they drive our revenue, but there's also another cost aspect, right? The number of instances that we're using to serve our load. And in today's highly dynamic environments where we can spin up new instances as our load increases, or as our application infrastructure cannot cater for the current load, right? It becomes very dangerous to have this cost go out of control, right? It explodes in our faces, and we want to make sure that we can control that, or at least monitor that early on, because this could be an early sign, not just for increased cost, but for architectural inefficiencies, right? Think memory leaks, for example. So in a Kubernetes world, we could just take per workload the number of running pods and put an objective against that. So, you know, as it is for our 5 top metrics, right, our 5 top SLOs, this is what our customers are looking at. But Wolfgang, you have one last point you want to highlight for non-production environments as well.
Yes, right. Thanks, Christoph. To finally take us home, I want to point out that we were talking a lot about the end user aspects, production monitoring aspects, where you really measure what impacts the end user or directly your costs. But also consider doing more earlier in the life cycle. So doing more measurements also throughout your software delivery pipeline, where you count more on non-functional requirements. But as we are not here to talk about that, our colleagues are. And really check out their sessions to do the shift left with your SLOs. So at the end, again, thanks a lot for joining.
Thanks, everybody.